Hello students, how are you? And you are able to give any response because it is not a live session, but you can comment. How are you and how you are able to understand, how much you are able to understand the topic that I am explaining in this video. Dear students, as the first chapter has been completed and that was the life process, some quiz questions I given to you to check, justify your concept, and the response is very good and you people are giving, scoring very good in those quizzes. Now you should try to learn some more things, and today in this second chapter which I am going to so in this video, this chapter is somewhat new in comparison of the first chapter, because in first chapter the processes like the respiration, transportation, working of heart, nutrition, excretion, you studied these processes many times and these are also discussed at the home regularly in ordinary house. So those things were quite easy and understandable because you have some concept about that. This chapter is also not new, but this chapter you not studied too many times in the previous classes, so you have to pay more attention, and it is the system of the book or the chapters that they are arranged in such a manner that the difficulty level increases. Okay, let's begin the second chapter, and it is the control and coordination. Okay, students, there are different life processes, and those life processes, their name is life processes because they are necessary for the survival of life of the organism, to maintain the homeostasis of the body. You can able to name them. I am giving you a short form. You can use this Mr. N. See here, this M is for movement. This R for respiration, T for transportation, E for excretion, and N for nutrition. Okay, some are saying that R for reproduction also. Question mark. Why? My answer is, life processes are those processes which are necessary for a living, to maintain its life, to for the survival of life of the organism. Okay, reproduction has no effect on the survival. It ensures the existence of a particular species on the earth. It has no benefit in the survival. Okay, so it will not consider in the life process. Respiration, transportation, excretion, and nutrition. These are four processes you studied in the first chapter. In this chapter, we will study about this one, and that is the movement. Okay, this is the introductory part of the chapter, and this introduction, in this introduction, I am trying to build some concept about the control and coordination. I will talk general things. that will make you to understand and form a base for the further topics. Dear students, movements are the important characteristics of all living organisms. Do you think? All living organisms? Movements are the important characteristics of all living organisms. Different living organisms like plants and animals show different kind of movement. Okay? Different kind of movement. One is called the growth movement. You know, plant and animals means all livings grow. So one of this movement is the growth movement. You can take the example of a germinating seed that grows, enabling the seedling to come out of the soil. That is the movement related to the growth. The seed germinate, increase in the shape, size, and as a result, the seedling come out of the soil. That is the growth movement. Non-growth movements are also there. Non-growth movements. These movements are not related to the growth. This non-growth movement, as the name itself enough, it is not related to the growth. You can take example here, like folding and drooping of touch me not plant leaves. Leaves are touch me not plant, folded and drooped when it senses touch, and it is not related to growth. It will come in its original shape after some time. Okay. In animals also, this type of, like the blinking of eyelids, a cat is running, a boy is shouting or swinging, a buffalo is chewing the cud, these all are not related to growth. But we observe these movements, and these movements will show that an organism is living or not. Okay? These all movements, do you know what is the reason of these all movements? The reason of these all movements are the changes in the environment. These all movements are in response to the changes in the environment. Okay? And changes in the environment which make an organism to respond are called stimuli. Okay? So you can write here, you will get a definition here. Changes in environment to which an organism respond are called stimuli. Stimuli. It is plural number. Singular is stimulus. Okay? Changes in the environment. What kind of change they are? You can take the environmental factors like cold, heat, touch, taste, smell, sound, force of gravity, water current, and many more things. That is different from the factors of atmosphere, environment, which we study in geography. We are talking about the leavings. Okay? So these are some stimuli. And many more stimuli are also there. These are some of the stimuli, and these stimuli induce the movements in organisms. Because of these stimuli, the organisms respond to stimulus or stimuli. Now, You can take the example, like you had seen that plant bends towards the sunshine, towards the light. That is a movement, that is a response for the light. You can take the example, a cat is running. Why the cat is running? What will be the stimulus? Maybe it has seen a mouse. Or maybe it has been chased by a dog. A child is enjoying the swing. For what? For getting fun, for getting pleasure. Okay? The buffalo is chewing the cud. Why? It is because it trying to break down the tough components of food, make them easier to digest. So these are the reasons, these are the stimulus to which these organisms show different types of movements. Dear students, all these, you can take one more example, like whenever we touch a hot object, we suddenly pull our hands back. Why? To escape ourselves, to protect us from burning, hurting. So these all movements are for the advantage. These all movements are for the advantage of organisms, for the survival of organisms, to maintain the homeostasis in the body. Okay? So this is, you get one definition here, it changes in the environment to which an organism respond or responds. So the response is called, are called stimuli, singular is stimulus. Dear students, have you think plant do not have nervous system? We have the nervous system, animals have the nervous system, but plant do not have the nervous system. But they are able to perceive the changes in the environment. That's why they show the movement. They are fixed at a location, they are fixed to the soil or substratum by root or root-like structures. They also not able to move. They do not have the nervous system. Then how they are able to sense the changes in the environment? And the answer is, they have the plant hormones. And those plant hormones work in the plant to respond to the changes in the environment in two ways. There are also, those hormones work in the plants in two ways. One is by growing parts. By growing parts, like bending of shoot towards the light, it is a growth movement, and this growth is induced by the plant hormones because of light. And second thing, by changing the shape, by changing the shape of cells, by changing the amount of water in them. Plants, hormones enable the plant to respond to stimulus in two ways, by growing its parts, just like bending a shoot. You can take here the example, bending of shoot towards light or away from gravity. And here you can take the example of folding and drooping. The leaves of mimosa. Mimosa, touch me not. Okay? Mimosa. So the plant hormones act in two ways. Among animals, the response, way of response is different. How different? Because animals have the nervous system. Some animals, simple animals like amoeba, They respond to stimulus in their surrounding, changes of environment in their surrounding, either by moving towards it or by moving away from it. Either moving towards stimulus, I am talking about animals. So if their reaction, if their response is in the form of moving towards the stimulus, this movement is called positive response. Positive response. And if they are moving away from stimulus, then their response will call the negative response. Okay? Similarly, all organisms, not only this amoeba, single cell organism or simpler organisms, all either they move towards the stimulus or they move away from the stimulus. Means their response may be positive or negative. Okay? You can take some example, like if amoeba senses a food particle around it, what it will do? It will move towards the food particle to engulf it. And that shows the positive chemotaxis. Moving towards food. And I am talking about amoeba, means simple organisms. Okay? So this is called the positive chemotaxis. Okay? Positive, as you know, it is because of moving towards the stimulus. Chemo means chemical. Food has the organic chemicals. And taxis is the response movement of single cell organisms. That is called taxis, and its plural is taxis. Taxis. The movement of single cell organisms in response to the stimulus is called taxis, and its single is taxis. Okay? Similarly, they also respond to heat. The amoebae plural, they collect together. If the water become hot or moderate heat, that will enable the amoebae to collect together in order to prevent the effect of hot water. Similarly, they are also respond to any mechanical obstacle. How? By avoiding them. And if they are avoiding obstacle, mechanical obstacle, this will negative taxis, because they are moving away from the stimulus. Okay? They are collecting together to avoid the effect of hot water, that will call the thermotaxis. Thermo means heat, you know. Thermotaxis. Okay? So this is how the simple organisms respond to stimulus. But what about the multicellular? Multicellular organisms are not having simple body structure. All of the cells in their body are not in contact with the surrounding environment. That's why the response to the stimuli by the multicellular organisms, higher organisms, is different. And the response to specific stimulus is also different. Okay, multicellular organisms do not have the simple body structure. They have million number of cells in their body. So, they respond to specific stimuli in different ways. And their different ways, because of having a complex body structure, only one organ or one cell is not able to respond. So, they need to respond in organized and this organized way of response involve many organs and involvement of many organs for a single work is called coordination. Simple way. The process in which the different body parts are involved in proper manner to produce a proper response is called coordination. Simple. You can take the example, like if we take an example of inhibition. Inhibition, you know, it is a step in getting the nutrition. Nutrition is whole life process and one of the step inhibition. Now think about, here is the food in the center. We ingest the food. This food is located by eyes. Eyes locate the food. Okay. Then hand picks the food. Okay. Mouth receives the food. Tongue tastes the food. Nose registers the smell. Teeth grind the food. And tongue also add saliva to make it easy to swallow. Okay? So see this, how many organs? Eyes, hands, mouth, tongue, means mouth, buccal cavity. Okay? Tongue, nose, teeth. These all organs are worked together. For what? To ingest the food. Eyes locate the food, hand pick the food. Mouth means buccal cavity receive the food, tongue taste the food and saliva to make it soft and easy to digest, nose register the smell and teeth help in the grinding of the food. Okay, so these all organs are working coordination. These all organs are working coordination and these all organs need to work in coordination in order to complete one function. And that is the inhibition. Okay, so in multicellular organisms, there are different body organs are involved in a proper manner to perform a proper reaction, proper activity. And this involvement of organ to perform a proper reaction is called coordination. So you can say coordination is the process in which the different body parts or organs are worked together in a proper manner to perform a specific function or specific response. Okay. Now, this is control and coordination. In simple organisms, if we take the example of amoeba as I take it, simple organisms have the nervous system. Their cells are in contact with the surrounding, so they are easy to perceive. They will able to get the perception about the changes and they respond easily. Plant have the plant hormones, do not have the nervous system. But development of multicellularity, evolution of multicellularity require the development of a specific system of control and coordination for activities of different cells. There are different cells, they all have to function the same. And how they coordinate, how they will function in coordination, this requires the development of a specific function to achieve the control and coordination between the cells. This system of control and coordination require, what it require? One is the gathering of information. Gathering of information from surrounding. Second, transmitting the information to the cells located far off, far, F-A-R, far off from body surface. And third, share the information, sharing the information as well as receive also to all cells of the body. You know, there are many cells which are lies deep inside the body, there are many cells who are lies at the body surface. So those cells which are not in direct contact with the surrounding, who are not lying at the body surface, they will not receive any sense of the change in the environment. Then how will they coordinate with the function? So for this three requirements are there in order to develop a system of control and coordination. And this control and coordination in multicellular organisms are achieved by two systems, and those two systems perhaps you heard previously or you will heard just now. And those two systems which achieve the control and coordination in multicellular organisms are nervous system. This system composed of nerve cells, means neurons. They bring coordination, control and coordination by nerve impulses, means electrical impulses that are also called nerve impulses. Their system, their function is, these are speedy, flexible, but localized. Their function is speedy, flexible and localized, means wherever the neurons are present in the body, they will coordinate only those regions with the system of the body. But what about those locations of the body where neurons are not present? So another system is also found, that is the endocrine system or neural control system. Endocrine system, chemical coordination. Okay, that is the second system of the body is endocrine system. The students, this system composed of glands, endocrine glands. Okay, they bring what? Control and coordination by chemical messengers, because they secrete chemicals. They bring control and coordination by chemical messengers, and these chemical messengers are called hormones. Okay, their action are usually slow and diffused. Okay, not localized. So there are two types of the systems are found in multicellular animals: nervous system and endocrine system. In plants, there is only the chemical system, hormonal system, they achieve the control and coordination by secreting the hormones. In simple animals, only nervous system is there. Okay, so this discussion is about the giving you introduction of this chapter. In next video, we will study about the nervous system in somewhat detail. What are neurons? What is their structure? How many types they have? And how they involve control in maintaining the homeostasis in the body by maintaining control and coordination? What will be the role of brain? What will be the spinal cord? And different things we will study in next video. Till then, if you able to understand something, then it is very good. And if you are able to understand something, then you should also subscribe, like, share and comment. Okay, it will be your duty also. Subscribe, like, share. Okay, if you want, you can comment also. Okay, the students, this was Girish Kumar Singh speaking with you. And hope you will remain safe, because COVID is spreading day by day. Now it become localized. Okay, so it is most important time in our locality to protect ourselves from this pandemic by staying at our home. We are working hard to provide you the teaching materials, study materials at your home. Study properly and make our effort success. It is you who can make only us success. Thank you. Thank you very much.